All right, is this thing going? I think so. Hey guys, welcome back. It's your girl, Chef Jazz here from Green Panther Chef, where we normalize cooking with cannabis. I'm also the author of More Than a Cannabis Cookbook, and I am a chef and a Crohn survivor. So what all that means is just I am very intentional about cooking with cannabis, and I love to share everything that I know. So in turn, hopefully it can help you. All right. So throughout the process, I did say that I had just authored my first cookbook, More Than a Cannabis Cookbook. I'll leave a link somewhere around here so you can check it out. But through that, I've gotten a lot of questions, a lot of just kind of like, Jazz, I am really interested in cooking with cannabis and having my first edible experience, but I hear about some of like the horrendous experiences of other people. So I'm just really scared. Are there any tips? So yes, indeed. Stay tuned, guys, because I want to share my 7 ultimate tips so you can enjoy your first edible experience. All right, let's get into it. Hey guys, so we had to change it up just a little bit. These are my 7 tips in order for you to enjoy your first edible experience. All right, so let's hop into it really quickly. Number 1, first off, you're going to have to determine dispensary or homemade. I always recommend starting off with a dispensary just because they have a more regulated process than someone who is making edibles inside of their kitchen or at home. You know, if you really want to determine your dose, which is 2, you're going to have to know how much THC is inside of that recipe. We are not going to leave you hanging. If you definitely want to start dosing at home, I have left a resource. Just click the links below. It is called Our Big 5. It's the tips, the 5 questions that you're going to have to ask yourself so you can start dosing at home. So make sure you click that and check it out. All right. So 2, determine your dose. You have probably heard it 1,000 times before, go low and go slow, but this is absolutely true. I'm talking about as low as 2.5 milligrams of THC and under per serving. And per serving is around every 90 minutes, right? And start to feel how that feels in your body. So starting low, going slow, and then moving up. I actually can go all the way up to 25 to 50 milligrams per day. Like I said, I am a Crohn survivor. I manage pain, all that good type of stuff. But this has taken years, and this has taken years of 0.3 journaling and being patient. So through the process of being diagnosed with Crohn's disease, dropping down to 84 pounds, all of that stuff, you know, I really had to learn what worked for me. And so I really had to be patient through the process. And I also had to journal through the process as well. That's the best way in order for you to create repeatable results. I work with a lot of clients and we can, they can take cannabis and dose and go up to 100 milligrams one day and have the perfect, you know, outcome. But then the next day they might try something or a different cultivar that just doesn't work for their symptoms, their body. And it's like, hey, I did the exact same process, but it's like, did you write down what was the cultivar? What was the method? How did you consume it? All that good type of stuff. So just being patient. Keeping a journal is extremely important. I talk about this a lot in the More Than a Cannabis Cookbook, but that has been the fundamentals and the crux of a lot of people's success when they're starting to cook with cannabis and they want to have just more than one edible experience. They really want to use this for health and happiness, right? So 4, I have to throw this in here. Get comfortable. In this culture, sometimes we are peer pressured to do things, especially things that sometimes we don't want to do. But if you are interested in consuming cannabis, make sure it's not in a peer pressure type of environment and you can really just relax and feel the benefits of cannabis. So if that's Netflix and chilling, if that is knitting, if it's cooking, if it's watching this channel, if it's whatever, just make sure it's something that you enjoy so it doesn't trigger any adverse effects whatsoever. All right, so we're going to hop on this side of the screen now. Now, stay hydrated. This does not have to apply to cannabis, but it still definitely applies to just health and happiness, right? Staying hydrated is definitely the crux of any health plan, or if you just definitely want to start enjoying edible experiences a little bit more, you definitely just want to make sure that you are hydrated and you are this, yeah, period. I'm not going to ramble. Drink your water, guys. period. Number seven, is that number six? Number six, fill up. Fill up. What does that mean? Eat. You cannot consume cannabis on an empty stomach. If you do, if that's your thing, okay, more power to you. But a lot of people can have different effects. If you have a higher metabolism, you'll feel the effects of cannabis probably a little bit more. If you don't eat, you can probably have adverse effects, you know? So just make sure that you consume like a great meal and then consume your cannabis. I actually was working with a client and we were on a clubhouse and she was telling me how she kind of gets around the whole mind trick of getting a edible candy bar. Let's say it's 100 milligrams in this edible candy bar. And she wants to consume the whole thing, but she knows her number and that is 10 milligrams. And so she can only have one square of this candy bar, but she's like, darn it, I really want the whole thing. So what she does is she buys two. She buys one that is infused and she buys one that isn't. So she takes her recommended dosage and then she enjoys the other half. So I was like, you know what? I have to share this with people. That is so awesome. So yeah, guys, make sure that you do put something on your stomach. And yeah, because you can definitely love the taste of it and just keep going and going and going. And then 2 hours later, you're in the fetal position. We don't want that whatsoever. That brings us to our last tip. Bad trips are actually part of the experience. Hopefully with these tips and all that good type of stuff, we can kind of circumvent that a little bit. But if you do have a bad trip, please do not beat up on yourself. It's definitely a part of the process, but hopefully you did have your journal handy so you know that you don't have to go down that road again. All right, so if you like this, please make sure that you like, comment, and share, subscribe, all that good type of stuff, and check out our debut cookbook, More Than a Cannabis Cookbook, that is available for pre-sale. All right, guys, until next time, much love.